Madison Productions presents Wanderer of the Wasteland by Zane Grey, narrated by Michael Kramer. Dedicated to my wife, Lena Elise Grey, without whose love, faith, spirit, and help I never could have written this novel. Zane Grey. Chapter 1. Adam Larry gazed with hard and wondering eyes down the silent current of the Red River upon which he meant to drift away into the desert. The Rio Colorado was no river to trust. It chafed at its banks as if to engulf them. Muddy and thick, it swirled and glided along in flood, sweeping in curves back and forth from Arizona to California shore. Majestic and gleaming under the hot sky, it swung southward between wide green borders of willow and cottonwood toward a stark and naked upflung wilderness of mountain peaks, the red ramparts of the unknown and trackless desert. Adam rushed down the bank and threw his pack into a boat. There his rapid action seemed checked by the same violence that had inspired his haste. He looked back up at the dusty adobe town of Ehrenberg, asleep now under the glaring noonday heat. It would not wake out of that siesta till the return of the weary gold diggers or the arrival of the stagecoach or the steamer. A tall Indian, swarthy and unkempt, stood motionless in the shade of a wall, watching stolidly. Adam broke down then. Sobs made his utterance incoherent.
"Gert is no brother of mine anymore,"
he burst out. His accent was one of humiliation and cheated love.
"And as for her, I'll never, never think of her again."
When once more he turned to the river, a spirit wrestled with the emotion that had unnerved him. Adam Larry appeared to be a boy of 18, with darkly tanned, clear-cut and comely face and a lofty stature, straight and spare and wide. Untying the boat from its mooring, he became conscious of a singular thrill. Sight of the silent river fascinated him. If it had been drink that had fortified his reckless resolve, it was some strange call to the wildness in him that had stirred exultation in the prospect of adventure. But there was more. Never again to be dominated by that selfish Gerd, his brother who had taken all and given nothing. Gerd would be stung by this desertion. Perhaps he would be sorry. That thought gave Adam a pang. Long habit of being influenced and strength of love fostered in playmate days, these made him waver. But the tide of resentment surged up once more, and there flowed the Red Colorado, rolling away to the southwest, a gateway to the illimitable wastes of desert land with its mystery, its adventure, its gold and alluring freedom.
"I'll go," he declared passionately,
and with a shove he sent the boat adrift and leaped over the bow to the rowing seat. The boat floated lazily, half-circling, till it edged into the current. Then, as if grasped by unseen power, it glided downstream. Adam seemed to feel the resistless current of this mysterious river take hold of his heart. There would be no coming back, no breasting that mighty flood with puny oars. The moment was sudden and poignant in its revelation. How swiftly receded the cluster of brown adobe huts, the somber, motionless Indian. He had left Ehrenberg behind, and a brother who was his only near relative, and a little sum of love that had failed him.
"I'm done with Gert forever,"
he muttered, looking back with hard, dry eyes. "It's his fault. Mother always warned me.
Ah, if she had lived, I would still be home. Home, and not here, in this awful desert of heat and wastelands, among men like wolves and women like—"
He did not finish the thought, but from his pack he took a bottle that glittered in the sunlight and, waving it defiantly at the backward scene of glare and dust and lonely habitation, he drank deeply. Then he flung the bottle from him with a violent gesture of repulsion. He had no love for strong drink. The bottle fell with hollow splash, rode the muddy swirls, and sank. Whereupon Adam applied himself to the oars with long and powerful sweep. In that moment of bitter soliloquy, there had flashed through Adam Larry's mind memories and pictures of the past, the old homestead back east, vivid and unforgettable.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.